Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear MGTOWs, dear big boys out there. As usual, hoping that all is fine, and should be the case right? We are taking our lives back, in our hands and full control. Thus how can life not be great for our kind? Okay. Again another article from the Reddit forums within the REDDCOIN section found that may have some interest for you guys. The struggle for meaning. We've all been there. You, me, your drug dealer, the ice cream man, the women you've slept with, and even your therapist. It gets called all manner of things. Depression, a plateau, a shit day, being overwhelmed, a lack of motivation, etc. It's also the one thing that separates the men from the boys. It's called meaning. Every last person on earth struggles to find meaningfulness in their lives. When we're faced with the inevitability of living every day over, and over, and over again, facing the same problems, doing the same things, putting in the time and getting results yet not truly feeling fulfilled, what is wrong? You're struggling to find meaning in your life. What is the abyss? Nietzsche, in Beyond Good and Evil, is well known for this quote. Beware that, when fighting monsters, you yourself do not become a monster, for when you gaze long into the abyss gazes also into you. It's a warning of the most important kind. The first half of the statement is an aphorism that generally holds true. We see it apply in the real world on the daily. However, Nietzsche isn't warning us about common wisdom. He's warning us about something far more sinister. The abyss is nihilism. When we discover the external truth of nihilism, we realize that in the big scheme of things, life is meaningless. If we accept the external truth that life is meaningless, we, in turn, make our very life meaningless. We become the very thing that we struggle against on the daily. If your life is meaningless, why continue living? Internal versus external truth and perception. Perception is the difference between the external actuality and our internal reality. It creates the reality we operate in. This is critical to understand. Female solipsism is an example of the reality that women operate in. For them, it is how the world simply works. Male reality is different than female reality, but it is no less true for them than our reality is for us. External truths lead to the conclusion that life is meaningless. Concepts like superdetermination, predestination, fate, eternal recurrence, and or the sheer insignificance of our existence in comparison to the actuality of the universe. These concepts, while probably true in actuality, are not a part of our perceived reality. Internal truths are the things that people believe in, like morality, free will, and ethics. The only internal truth that matters most is the perception of free will. The ability to choose our perception with our personally created free will is the difference between becoming the abyss and telling it to go fuck itself. Your free will is the barrier between incorporating meaninglessness into your perception and making your life meaningless, or incorporating meaningfulness into your life and thereby giving yourself purpose. Escaping the abyss. Our perceived reality is exactly what we are. It is your perception, and yours alone, that decides whether you have meaning or not. The internal truths are ones of our own creation, and we shape and abide by them according to our free will. Morality, a self-imposed truth. Integrity, a self-imposed truth. A personal mission, a self-imposed truth. You choose your purpose. You choose your mission, you choose to give yourself meaning. Our perceived free will gives us that power. Nietzsche wrote this in The Gay Science. What, if some day or night a demon were to steal after you into your loneliest loneliness and say to you, this life as you now live it and have lived it, you will have to live once more and innumerable times more. Would you not throw yourself down and gnash your teeth and curse the demon who spoke thus? Or have you once experienced a tremendous moment when you would have answered him, you are a god and never have I heard anything more divine? Even if you were predetermined to live the same pitiful existence over and over and over again for all eternity, that external truth is something you cannot change. However, that external truth can be perceived by your internal reality as something else. Do not abide the abyss. It is against everything we are as men. You give yourself meaning, and that means having the mental fortitude and wisdom to reject the external truths that lead to nihilism and accept only the truths that you set for yourself. People's internal truths are not your internal truths. As blue pill as it sounds, It's what is on the inside that matters, not the external bullshit that you let into your reality. Guard your reality fervently, and when you allow a single soul entrance into your world, you are giving them a gift beyond measure. Realize too, that other men have similar realities, and they can guide you towards building and guarding the personal truths that make a man a man. The path can be shown, but only you can walk it. And once you start, the abyss will be left behind. Okay, let me spice this a bit up. That was a cool article, nice and all, but at the same time, contemplation of the abyss makes you feel lively. Sadly, life is an experiment and one cannot fully base himself out of his own internal values, because since birth other people beliefs, parents, relatives, friends, then education and school, then workspace and colleagues, etc. are all forcing their belief at one point or another to the individual, which in the early stages of his own life, cannot define the limits between what's internal and what's external. He cannot weight them and judge them either. Basically, it does not work. You can only limit the external inputs into your life. Same with religion, imposed by the family where you were born into, culture, society, etc. You can only try to find another way when you have reached the maturity for that into adulthood, when the damage has already been severely done. That's why I call a bit bullshit on this one, because it's not so easy to keep your realities. And you do not really have your own realities, only a combination of external ones. How can someone know his true self, if it is not biased by the environment? Let's take an example. Some plants can only grow under certain specific conditions of warmth, temperature, sunlight, humidity, type of ground, rocks, sand. And the growth rate is also based on the best of all the environment can bring, nutrients, etc. An algae will never grow on desert land straightforward. Of course, by putting a special water tank you will be able to perform the needed feats so that this plant can grow there. You can trick things, do some tinkering, but it will never be 100% natural way it should have been. You will never succeed without tricks to raise bananas into the Alaska. Greenhouses can help, but this is an alternation of the environment. It is the same for men. They cannot and will most likely never be themselves, as it is impossible to fully grow alone and be yourself alone. You have some of your beliefs that are for sure already ones from the outside. You may stick to some, reject others, but it never came from your own, never came from yourself. The only thing that may be possible to change is the perception of the external inputs ingrained into you. You can only hinder or amplify those core beliefs, but they most probably are not your own. At least that's how I view things. It's up to you guys to confirm or not if true.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.